Everything began with the Industrial Revolution in 1750, which gave birth to the capitalist system. In 2.5 centuries, the so-called developed countries have consumed a large part of the fossil fuels created over 5 million centuries. Global warming is one of the top problems faced by our world. We were studying about this global warming from 4th standard itself. The whole earth is under threat because of this global warming. What is the cause of it? The pollution made by the mankind is the main reason for the global warming. The carbon dioxide produced by vehicles, firewood, etc., and reaction of carbon contents and combustion of plastic, etc. Since carbon dioxide is less dense than air, it covers the topmost portion of the atmosphere. What can we do for solving this? This is the question which makes us think of the future. Here we are showing you the steps to be taken and already took by various institutions. First of all, we have stopped pollution air. Use biodegradable products instead of today's plastic or the artificial polymers like polythene. Check pollution stats of our vehicle frequently. Reduce the use of fuel like gasoline, ethanol, petrol, diesel, etc. And use fuels like hydrogen, electricity, LPG, marsh gas, etc. Stop cutting up woods. Let's start afforestation. Global warming is generating abrupt changes in the weather. The retreat of glaciers and the decrease of the polar ice caps, the increase of sea level and the flooding of coastal areas, where approximately 60% of the world population live. The increase in the processes of desertification and the decrease of freshwater resources, a higher frequency in natural disaster that living in this world, we should just be concerned about our own welfare. We should also care for all living beings. The noble earth has bestowed the human beings with incredible and beautiful nature in the form of mountains, rivers, forests, and various natural resources that help human beings to survive and initiated our evolution. So now,
the heat radiation from the sun reaches earth and reflect back the axis of earth by earth's crust. This layer of carbon dioxide does not allow heat energy to escape from the earth atmosphere, which result in rise of temperature irreducibility. Then the after effect, the earth skin burns, water rot, drying of plants and dehydration has an influence in due to high air pollution.
What I feel is that first and the foremost thing what human being has to do is to plant more and more trees. In today's development scenario, where the infrastructure is developing so fast, trees are being cut for making dams, roads, buildings, and they are not being replenished. What I think is that at least 3 times the tree should be planted. That means whenever you cut one tree, you should plant 3 trees. That is one part. Second part is conservation of the energy. Due to increase in the energy, we are generating energy from air, from coal, and thermal plants are being set up. Again, when the charcoal is being used, they are eating away the resources of the earth. So these are the two important things which we should do to conserve the energy. Thank you.
time till now in your life?
Yeah, why not? We have also planted so many trees. In front of our house itself, we have done a plantation. Then we have got a club. We are a member of Lions Club of Indore Citizen, in which there are so many club members who are having their industries, and we have gone and done the plantation over there. Not only that, in Indore, there is a place named as Gomadgiri, where the mass plantation was done by the people of Indore. So many persons, clubs joined together, and now if you go and see, the trees have become grown up and they are very green and giving lot of oxygen to the human beings.
The Earth is said to be alien planet.
Due to the insensitive exploitation by human being for its survival and development, the Earth has lost most of its vital resources. With drying rivers, depleting and polluting environment, deteriorating forest and greenery, the Earth is now breathing very hard, and thus it is known to be an ailing planet.
I would also like to ask you that we as research workers should not campus in making documentaries on the topic sustainable living for an ailing planet. So what are your views on this?
I think the school has done a very good activity by making the children involved in making the documentaries. I think this must be done in small groups. In fact, the school should also make a competition between all the students and give an award to the successful group. Not only that, these documentaries which are made by the students should be shown to the parents, because in nowadays parents are too much busy in their activities and they are also not aware about the saving of the Mother Earth. So in fact, children will help their parents to understand the ailing planet much better.
Up to predictions, leading to a crisis of confidence.
Thank you. refer to the fact that our planet, the Earth, is suffering from various problems like environmental degradation, pollution, etc. So sustainable living is all the effort that we should make in order to make our Earth a better place to live in.
What do you think people should do to conserve our Mother Earth?
I think that the basic efforts should start from the ground level. The basic step that we should do is to avoid pollution by using more of bicycles for short distances, by using public transport, avoiding transport for one single person, like people often use cars just for one single person to travel. In that case, they should go in for public transport. Moreover, we should avoid throwing litter in the public places. We should be more cleanliness conscious. We should provide bins at every corner of the street. And basically, I think that people should be aware. And once we spread awareness, and we should also go in for the 3 R's, reduce, recycle, and reuse.
Anything that you have done till now to save our Mother Earth?
Yes, I have participated in various cleanliness drives, whereby we go to the villages, we spread awareness among the people, and moreover, we've also focused on planting more trees.
I would also like to ask that we, students of Chaitanya School North Campus, is doing activities like making documentary on the topic sustainable living for our alien planet. What are your views on this?
I think this is an extremely wonderful idea, because when students sit together, they make documentaries, they discuss the various ills that are happening around us, and they become aware. And definitely when young minds get together, they can give better ideas for environmental conservation. I think such activities should be promoted because they are for the well-being of the society.
Thank you, ma'am.
You're welcome.
There are many ways through which we all can contribute in the protection and conservation of and keeping the earth clean. We should also try to lessen the use of natural resources so that there will be enough resources for the coming generation as well. We should find solutions to protect an endangered species as they are essential part of our flora and fauna. Conservation groups should open more and more wildlife sanctuaries, national parks and biosphere reserves. For instance, there are very less number of tiger left on the earth. For this, AIRCEL has launched an awareness campaign to save tigers, in which they convince people to write articles and blogs to aware people across the world. People should try to use public transportation instead of personal vehicle, as it will help in reducing pollution to great extent. Lesser the number of vehicles, lesser will be the pollution. People should use CNG instead of petrol in their vehicles, as it will bring the pollution level down. We should lessen the usage of insecticides and pesticides in the field, as all the chemicals make the soil fertile. Next thing we can do is to completely avoid the usage of plastic bags, as they are extremely harmful for our environment. The factors responsible for depletion of natural resources like carbon emissions from industries, depletion of ozone layer from atmosphere, and man-made activities which cause threat to our environment should be brought under control by creating eco-friendly devices and techniques. As a new initiative to protect the Earth, the concept of Earth Hour has been started, which is observed in the month of March every year, in which people all over the world switch off the lights and devote in saving the environment. Demonstrations are carried out by the conservation groups at various levels in the form of seminars, debates, and discussions by the eminent personalities. We all know that water is essential for everyday lives, and without water, life on earth is impossible. So if we change our water usage habits, like turning off taps while brushing our teeth, taking shower instead of bath, fixing the leaking faucet, etc., can save billions of gallons of water. Most animals are being killed for their fur and skin, which has led to threat of extinction of these animals. By minimizing the use of animal products can stop these cruelties towards these animals. To save endangered animals, most important thing you can do is to preserve their habitats.
Can you explain a small intro about My name is Yogesh Chaudhary, and I am pursuing CS Handling Student. I have completed my MBA, so I have complete knowledge about sustainable development. Please just ask me about.
Sir, my question is, my first question is, what can you explain what is sustainable development?
Okay, sustainable development means take care of natural resources while using. All natural resources like plant, you know, any plant, water resources, and all other natural activities which whatever you are using, so that our future generation can derive their benefit in same way. This is called sustainable development. Suppose you are using furniture, so it is made from wood. Finally, it means you have cut a tree for making a furniture, it means you have lost one tree. So it's your responsibility that you plant one tree. So this is a sustainable development.
My another question is, how we can save natural resources?
How can we save natural
resources?
How we
can conserve our
natural resources? Okay, okay. How can we conserve our natural resources? So many ways for conserving natural resources. If we talk about water, if we want to conserve water resources, so we should make a water conservation system in front of our home, and we should connect all the pipes of our terrace so that we can drop all the water into the that conservation system, drain water harvesting system. So it is the most important for conserving water and improving the water level of earth. And another thing is, if we talk about forest, so forest is cutting day by day just because of requirement of furniture and wooden items. So it's our responsibility that we plant more and more trees every year.
This is all right, but earthquake and floods can damage this sustainable development.
Somewhere earthquake and flood affect our sustainable development. How? If everything is running systematically and suddenly earthquake and the flood has come, so it may damage some particular areas. So in that case, it's our responsibility. Anyhow, we will make it good. Suppose earthquake has destroyed all the plants, so it's our responsibility that we plant new trees. And earthquake has destroyed all the earth, so it's our responsibility that somewhere we stop it.
In this case, what we should normal opinion for others
to do for sustainable development. Okay, my opinion and my message for society and the general public for conserving natural resources and for sustainable development. Every people should plant tree so that we can get a fresh air and we can reduce the pollution, because our trees conserve all carbon dioxide and it gives us oxygen, so it is very beneficial for us. So that's my final opinion to all public, that they do something for our nature like plantation and the conservation of water through water conservation systems and drain water harvesting, something like that.
Thank you.
Okay.
I'll stop him.
Renewable energy is considered to be clean sources of energy that produces little or no waste products such as carbon dioxide or other chemical pollutants, which minimize the impact on the environment. This helps in reducing global warming. Another main advantage, it is renewable and will never run out. It requires less maintenance, which is sustainable based on current and future economic and social needs. Destroying a paper costs a tree. Reducing the unwanted usage of papers will save the natural resources and prevent the planet from being polluted. So use natural resources wisely and not wastefully. Glass should be recycled because not only it takes a lifetime to decompose, but also it makes up a large component of industrial waste. The benefits of recycling are it reduces the amount of waste sent to landfills, which help to prevent water pollution, conserves natural resources such as timber, water, and minerals for future generations. The major cause of global warming is the result of burning fossil fuels and destroying tropical rainforests. Trees help to filter pollution from the air, create shades, give shelter, and also the food that we consume, and much more. Planting even one tree by a single person can make a huge difference. Without trees, there would be no life on this planet. The most simple and easy way to save energy is by turning off the lights when you are not in the room and unplugging the unused appliances. It only takes a few seconds to be environmentally conscious. These small changes we establish in our daily routine can lead to a big revolution. Put posters and banners in public and encourage those around you to read about the importance of saving nature. Organize campaigns like t-shirts and caps made with environmental awareness slogans written on it. This will help create awakening in the masses of how grave environmental problems are and what we can do to solve them. It is an opportunity for individuals, corporations, and government to come forward and join hands to create a new global green economy. Government is doing a lot in this regard, but merely imposing fines will not help. More stringent measures should be taken to combat the challenges which our Earth is facing today. It is a day to think of environmental challenges we face, how to solve them. It is the duty of all human beings and all countries to protect the earth responsibility. All together, we can make a difference. Cleaning up the earth must be viewed as part of evolution of human consciousness.
Biological systems being depleted?
If I answer on this, let me tell you, there are the four systems of the principle of the biological this thing. They are mainly fisheries, cropland, grassland, us. See the countries where the protein consumption is high. They are basically getting from the fisheries. They are depending on the fisheries. So the system of the fisheries is collapsed. And there are the grassland is converted into the desert. So this another system is being depleted. Now the main reason of this is our population. The reason the consumption of is increasing day by day. That is why these resources are being over consumed. And this is the reason this biological principle are being depleted because of the overpopulation.
Okay. Why does the author aver that the growth of world's population is one of the strongest factors distorting the future of human society?
See, the overpopulation, mainly what is depending, the demand of the things are depending on the, we are using our resources, what are available to us, on the basis of the need. The population is increasing, so the demand is increasing. While we are having the limited resources, so resources being used up to the larger extent. That is the reason author is saying that the overpopulation is the main cause which is causing harm to the resources.
The problems of overpopulation that directly affect our everyday life, what are these problems?
Could you please repeat your question?
The problems of overpopulation that directly affect our everyday life, what are these problems?
See, the problem of overpopulation is directly affecting our life in many ways. See, whatever if population is increasing, everything is being affected. You take these systems, these our man needs, or you take any system like traffic system or any other system. To control any system, we require proper management. But because of the increment into the population, many systems are being broken down. We are not having any control over these systems, directly or indirectly. So we have to find out the reason. We have to find out the solution. How we can control the population? And so our day-to-day activities are directly hampered with the increment of the population.
What do you think that if the glaciers will fell down in a huge amount and the government is not taking any action against it, what will happen to that country?
I would like to quote an example in the answer of this question. Few years back, there was a glacier fell down into the valley of the Kedarnath. So what happened? Because of this, there was flood has come and it has taken millions of their life. And the government was unable to do rescue operation at that time. Though we are having NDRF system, National Disaster Relief System, but they are not able to cope up with the present condition. The geological condition of the India at that place won't allow them to rescue operation. If government don't take the proper action, this will destroy the population, even many archaeological structure of the India.
What do you think, from where we have taken this earth, from our forefathers or from our children?
This is a very diplomatic question, and the diplomatic answer of this is, like, we have taken this earth from the not only from forefather. It's I should say that this is a gift of God to us. It is being beautifully designed by the God for the human beings.
Thank you.
This is not an isolated event. Only 200 years ago, the earth was pollution-free. But every increasing technological advance since the Industrial Revolution has rapidly put our planet on a collision course with destruction. Even if we wake up and pay attention to the condition of the planet, we must be clear in our consciousness. If not, history will repeat itself. If we make external changes but continue to live in same unconsciousness, the problem will have a temporary solution, and in time, the next generation will face the same all over again. Ongoing awareness is the only permanent solution. Our Earth is a living organism, an enormous being, of which we are parts. This is our planet. Its destruction will make us all homeless. We are dependent on Earth and not the other way around. However, the thankless creator, man, is unconcerned about the dangers that pose threats to our survival. A holistic and ecological view of the world has been brought into consideration. The Green Movement Law in 1972 has never looked back. There is a growing need of sustainable development, which was popularized by World Commission on Environment and developed in 1987.